A few more years down the track and Chris and Zach decided to buy land and build their home. They moved in and adopted a couple of rescue kittens from our lovely friend Dee. Thank you, Dee. Of my memory divides the thorns from the roses. It's you and the roses. So for Kristy, she came into the world on the 12th of March 1989. Like most siblings, she watched and followed her older sister Mel. Within a couple of years, we were going to Mel's first ballet concert, where she was dressed as a cat with ears, a tail, and whiskers. As I let you go, I will find my way when I see your eyes. Now I'm living.
Chris is also really creative. So when we were younger, we used to play a lot. We would make up games where I would be queen of the world and Chris was always the best friend or my boyfriend. Here I am, lost in the ashes of time, but who wants tomorrow? Dave as well, you've just been so great and so calm today, and I'm so happy to call you my sister-in-law. You've just been really great today and for the past 5 years as well. And before that, Dave was my friend when we were at AMC, and you were always just so lovely and welcoming. My mind drifts away. We only have today.
Touch me and I will follow. So Zach, as we have experienced, you have a great sense of humour. You talk a lot, but then again, so does Kristy, so you know, yeah. And all those little bits of hair that stick up in the air that we always were worried about with all your new hairstyles. And just in case you're wondering, today's or tonight's hairstyle is called the George Clooney. That's what Zach told us anyway.
Zach's one of the highest quality people I know, growing up with him all my life. You snag yourself one hell of a guy, Kristy. He's hardworking, he's smart, he's the funniest guy I know, and he's not that bad in the eye, really. And I have no doubt he'll be a great husband and even better father.
Zach, your family, and I'm speaking on behalf of them, I'm proud of you and your achievements. You, with your bride Kristy, have established a home and are now setting out in your own direction. As I let you go, I will find my way. I will sacrifice. Now I'm living in your afterglow.
Kristy, you look simply amazing tonight, but it's obvious to me and anyone who knows you that you are a beautiful person. You are passionate about anything you take your hand to, and I know you're going to be a fantastic wife to my brother, and I hope a great mother. The walls of my memory divide the thorns from the roses. It's you who is closer. Thank you to everyone who travelled a long distance, like Sven, Ben from the Gold Coast. We really appreciate it that you guys travelled those large distances for us. It means a lot to us as a family, and we just love sharing these kind of things with you. You fry me in a pan, you cook me in a can, you stretch me with your hands. You love to watch me bake, you set me up with cake, and that's your... So Zach, I'd really admire your hair, your athleticism, and your eagerness to wear hair and makeup and a dress with me. And I
I know, Kristy, that both Hans and Doreen would love you and would welcome you into our family as I do now.
I ask the people here present to witness that I, Kristen Leanne Ives, take you, Zachariah Hans Lachlan Troiger, to be my lawfully wedded husband. Zach, it's hard to sum up into a few sentences what you mean to me. You are my best friend. You are the person that makes me laugh until I cry, and the person that wraps me in your arms when I've forgotten how to smile. I never thought I would be lucky enough to find someone as special as you, and I can't imagine life without you. You are my everything. You are home to me. I promise to love you for the rest of our lives.
I ask the people here present to witness that I, Zachariah Hans Lachlan Troiger, take you, Kristen Leanne Ives, to be my lawfully wedded wife. Kristy, I love your strength, your courage and your determination. I love your enthusiasm to learn and experience new things. You always comfort and support me and encourage me to grow as a person, and I truly love you for that. I promise to love you, to care for you and to cherish you and our time together as long as we both shall live.
I could say that everyone was wrong. It must feel good to stand above me while I make you so proud of me. It must feel good that I'm now gone. I wish I
Kristy and Zach, with these vows that you have promised and these rings you have shared, I am very, very proud to announce that you are now officially husband and wife. Congratulations.
To say to Zach, welcome to the family. We're very happy and honoured to have you in our family. Thank you. And that includes Dean, Mel and Eliana. Yeah. Here's to Zach and Chris. Well done, guys.
So I staggered through the night.
As much as we joke, Dean and I couldn't be happier for you two. Today has been an awesome day, and it's such a relief we didn't have to buy you a husband.
So I never forget what the feeling's like. Gonna burn your name right across the sky. So I never forget what the feeling's like. I want every single soul to know that I love you for what you are.
So I'd like to say thank you again to everyone that came. It really means the world to us that you're all here, that you've journeyed from far and wide, from Bahrain, from the Gold Coast, and from Karina, Mel. It's just lovely that you could all be here. And today wouldn't be anything near what it is now if it wasn't for all of you. So we're really happy to have shared today with you, and we couldn't think of a better day to have had.
In a burst of broken.
It's not often in a parent's life that you get the opportunity to publicly acknowledge and hopefully embarrass your children. And when the opportunity arises, you take that and grasp it with both hands. Both proud of you, or we're all proud of you, and we're very pleased in the choices you have made and the manner in which you've conducted yourself, and we wish you only the best for the future you've chosen together.
everyone, yeah, have a great time. Thank you again so much for coming, and we love you so much.